Ghana's economy is heavily dependent on agriculture. More than 50% of the country's working force is estimated to be engaged in agriculture as their main source of employment. Most of them are small-scale producers. They apply little or no improved technology to their work. Most of them have no access to irrigational facilities. Their work is entirely dependent on rainfall. But 2015 has been a bad rain year.
We're supposed to have major season starting from April to August. And then the minor season also take over from that August to November and December. But looking at it, farmers were able to plan for the major season. The minor season, there's no rains. Even within the major season, there were no rains for the crops that they've planted to do well.
The result is lower yields on the farms, causing farmers huge losses, with an attendant threat to the nation's food security. I visit some farming communities to hear how this has left farmers in huge debt, starting from one of the nation's food basket towns, Techiman, in the Brong-Ahafo region. This is a farm in the Techiman North district of the Brong-Ahafo region. Well, here they grow maize, they grow yam, they grow cassava, and it's from this area and other parts of the Brong-Ahafo region that a lot of the foods that are consumed in Accra and other major towns are produced. The farmers complain that at this time of the year, when they've been expecting the rains, they've not come as they wanted it to. Let's speak to a farmer here. All our produce have gone bad. There has been no rain for the past 3 months. I took a loan of 1,100 cedis from the bank to do a 3-acre farm, but I can't pay back now.
Bank, it is an opportunity. It may buy fertilizer and ammonia and we are near Kutuaka. They say a dim my and say, but Matuya cannot cram or massa may be made a person.
Matthew Katia is the municipality's 2010 Best Farmer Award winner. He has invested about 3,000 cedis into maize farming this year, of which 1,200 cedis was a loan. But bad weather has claimed it all. The result, he has no money to even educate his children.
Me bohonka 12 million, first one.
1,200 new cedis. The first farm I planted, I spent more than 1,300 cedis on it, but no returns. My child, whose school's in Obuasi, needs to go back to school, but I don't have any money for him to go. Some of his colleagues have been left with no food to even eat at home.
Some of the crops begin to start, let's say, maize, and then the rain stop. So it has remained there. The farmers, some of the farmers cannot even harvest, because there's nothing in the field to harvest. And the crops needed rains at that time to be able to mature. And it wasn't, the rains was not coming, so they are not able to harvest. So many of the farmers, I think this time, what to eat themselves is even a problem, neither to talk of sending it to the market to sell.
Meet Tampoli Bugri, a maize, yam and cassava farmer here in Techiman. He also took a loan of 1,000 cedis from a local bank to finance his farming activities, which has now gone down the drain. The result, he can't even take care of his family. I have a 6-acre farm. I've spent more than 1,000 cedis on it, which was a loan I took from the bank. Now I can't pay back because of the poor rain. In the Ashanti region, the story is not different. Regional Agricultural Director Kweku Minkafojo says they are projecting a 30% yield loss this year because of the poor rainfall patterns.
In fact, we are projecting in Ashanti region a reduction of anywhere between 30 and 40% as compared to last year. In fact, yesterday I was in one of the districts and the demonstration that had been harvested, the yield was at most 20-25% of what we had expected.
And this is the demonstration?
Yeah, this is a demonstration farm. And what actually happened was that since the plant was planted and fertilizer applied 10 days after planting, there had never been any rain until harvest. Ashanti region has been a region which is a net exporter of food. And I foresee the quantities exported dwindling.
Up north, the situation is even worse. Most streams have dried up, just as crops in the field. I visit Dawuni Kwekufonjo. He farms a 5-acre plot in Jonanyule in the Nanumba North District. He complains all his toil has gone waste, leaving him with no money to feed his family.
I've been farming maize, but because of the rain patterns this year, in fact, I farmed about 5 acres and haven't planted. The rain season is raining, and the whole of that 5 acres, I have no maize from the place. Even half a bag, I will not get. This 5 acres, automatically the plowing alone is 2.5. Then I bought fertilizer. A fertilizer, a sack is to an acre, which is 5 fertilizer sacks. And here, 1 is million.
So that makes it 500 cedis in addition to the 250 cedis, 750. Yes. Any additional expenses?
Of course, yes, as a teacher, all this thing alongside, I have to take laborers. And what I've spent on the labor side is roughly 480 that I've spent. And all is in vain, because I can't get anything.
So you've invested more than 1,000 cedis on your farm.
Of course.
And all of that has virtually gone to waste.
Waste, because of no rains this year.
This may obviously leave you struggling for the rest of the year, won't it?
Of course. Because I'm a family hood. What will I use to feed the family?
You've got wife and kids. How many of them?
I've got 4 children with a wife, including myself. Roughly that is 6. So how do I feed them? It's a problem.
In this part of the country, almost every single adult you meet is a farmer. Bakwa Hassan is a farmer at Sakwili in the Savelugu-Nanton municipality. He cropped 17 acres of maize at the start of the season in April, into which he invested more than 3,000 cedis. The crop should have been ready for harvest by now, but the fields are dry. This community is called Sakwili. It's in the Savelugu district of the northern region. Here, the farmers mainly grow maize, they grow soybean, and they grow a lot of groundnut. Being a farming community, this is what they rely on year in and year out in order to raise money to take care of their families. But they are complaining that this year they are not getting adequate yield because of the poor rains, and they are worried that going into the next year, they would have a lot of difficulty raising enough money to feed themselves.
The rain is not coming here enough. First, it started well, and when we started farming, the rain stopped once again. And when the rain stopped, all the crop that we sow, they're all dead.
I can see, for example, the maize field there. Is this how it's supposed to look like? They look very short. Ordinarily, is this how they are supposed to look like?
No, because of late sowing.
And the late sowing was because you did not get the rains coming in on time.
Yeah, we are doubting that if rain didn't rain up to maybe October, we can't get food this year.
What do you mean by can't get food this year?
Yeah, the crop will not done.
And what kind of effect will that have on you, having to feed yourselves and your family and sell some even to raise money?
Our children's schools will not go. Even we ourselves will not get enough healthy, because if you don't eat, I don't think you can have well.
Traditional leaders are equally worried they have had little groundnut and soya bean to sell.
The Yeah,
what he's saying is that first the rain came. They went in, plowed and do planting and everything. For some time it stopped. So for that reason, all what they've invested has run at a loss. So they have to go back and till the soil again for replanting. So because of that, they don't even have granules here because the period for granules has elapsed.
I visit the Volta region to sample more views from farmers on this worrying development. Seth Kwame Amedome is a farmer at Achibikope in the KJB district. He estimates his loss so far to about 2,500 cedis. He is thus unable to buy cloth for his wife this year.
I've cleared about 2 acres of maize farm, and I spent almost about 3,000 cedis. And then the money which I got, I don't get even more than 4 million. So, in fact, it's a great burden to me.
That sounds like a very huge loss, meaning you lost more than 2,500 cedis?
Yes, I lost more than 2,500 cedis. So my children are suffering. School children, my wife, you see, they are suffering a lot. And we are praying to Almighty God so that if God permit her and we have good rainfall, then we may cover.
When you say your family, they are suffering, what does that mean?
Okay, that means if you are having a wife, and then the nakedness of a woman is very awkward. And then if you don't buy a cloth for a woman for a year, that means the house will be very hot. The house will be very hot. And then the children too, how their school fees, some are at the secondary school, their school fees to pay. In fact, it's a great burden to us. It's a great burden to us.
Cephas Tosenu is also a maize, rice and cocoa farmer here. He says the problem will make it impossible for him to pay back loans taken from the EDIF fund.
This year, the rainfall disappointed. So with our AES, we look to do this EDIF loan to support from the government so that we can do more or produce more rice. But fortunately, because of the rainfall, we didn't get any confidence or courage from the rainfall. And if you look at the environment, our decent maize production, because of the rainfall, it's very, very poor, and we didn't get anything. So our living condition this time is very, very, very hard. So we need a support from the government.
What kind of effect did that cause on your farm as far as the amount of yield that you expected to get is concerned?
Mm-hmm. I can say that for me particularly, it failed me in the way that I can't get enough money to establish my children to school first, to do my job or my work as a farmer. So I didn't get enough money for it. And I'm telling you that now my living condition is very, very hard or poor.
And the story is same at Nitahuta in the Akachi North District.
This time, it has to rain at this time for us to start planting, but there is no rain. That is the main problem we are facing now.
When should the rain have started and it's not coming so far?
Early August, around 20th, that way. Yeah.
Ordinarily, that's when the rains will come, yeah. But this time around, it's not coming.
Yeah, it's not coming at this time. So that's what we are contemplating about. Either it's going to rain or not. Yeah, yeah.
What kind of effect is that having on your maize produce and your produce of other and you producing other crops?
Yeah, well, normally when the rain comes late, when we plant around October, November, that way, we are getting to the Harmattan season. So it affects our crops and they don't grow well as we expect them to grow. Yeah.
District Chief Executive for Akachi North, James Gunu, says plans are underway to introduce irrigational facilities here.
What we can do is maybe have some dugouts, you know, smaller dams for them to do all year farming. We have one at Avafiarenyigba, you know, and there's one too at Ashiagbovi. And we have another dam to at Avedakpa, you know. So all these dams are in the district to ensure that, I mean, those who want to engage in irrigation, farming and other things also have the opportunity to do that.
As Agric Extension Agent Mujiz Abdullah explains, the introduction of irrigational agriculture is the surest solution to this problem.
I'm advising and suggesting that maybe we can switch into the irrigation system. Those communities and farmers that are closer to water bodies, we can, when the government begin to maybe at least help them, we can provide machines and then they will use the irrigation system. The little waters that are in the rivers and the streams, they can use that one to do their crops.
But Ashanti Regional Agric Director Minka Fojo says this is not feasible because most of the farms are small-scale ones.
This may be a private position, but all over the world, with the exception of perhaps India and China, irrigated agriculture has always been a small percentage of the total land under cultivation. So it is not surprising that in Ghana, the area under cultivation is less than 2%. However, we have conservation agriculture as a means to improve soil health and productivity. And by this, we limit the exposure of the soil by using crop residues to incorporate into the soils, and then also making sure that the soil is never exposed to the direct effect of the sun.
In the absence of any easy solution, lecturer at the Crop Science Department of the University of Cape Coast, Dr. Michael Oseidu, is encouraging farmers to resort to drought-resistant and early-yielding crop varieties to survive.
There are a number of options, but I think the one we can do immediately is to select for plants that are drought-resistant. So if a crop needs a certain amount of water to grow and to yield well, we can look for species that need limited amount of water to even give more or give the same amount of yield. That is one alternative we can take. Another alternative is to select for crops that mature earlier. Previously, for example, we used to have land races, and some of them could take 120, 150 days for maize. Now, some of them take 90, 95 days, early maturing maize. And it's because the rainy seasons are now reducing. So if you look for crops that mature earlier, also at the time, so that the time that the crop need the water most meets the rainy season, then of course we can maximize your yield. For instance, during the growth cycle of the crop, it needs the rains or the water when it is filling its grains, especially if you're talking about the cereals. So if you can sow at a time that the grain filling of the crop sinks with the rainy season, then it means that you're going to maximize the use of the water, and that those are some of the options we can take.
The farmers warn of looming food crisis in the country next year as a result of the drought problem.
I'm foreseeing that there will be a food shortage in the country, because if you look at it, everybody is saying brown halfway is the food basket. And now Techima as a whole is the food basket. Here is the case, the rain is not coming, especially in Techima here. So I'm foreseeing some food shortage in the system.
Ashanti Regional Agric Director Mr. Minka Fojo says farmers have already started feeling the pinch of the crisis, with maize prices doubling over the last 1 year.
Currently, maize sells at about 130 to 150 per maxi bag. Now, around this time last year, the same weight cost around 50-60.
So can you expect that for cereals like maize, the prices may even inch up further than the figures you've just been given?
Definitely, definitely. Mm-hmm. Unless there is importation, and I mean importation from outside the country, we expect prices to go through the roof. The poultry and livestock sector are likely to be seriously impacted, because if the price of maize goes up, it's only natural that the price of eggs will go up. Mm-hmm. A little under a year ago, a crate of eggs used to cost 8-9 Ghana cedis. Today is 14-16 Ghana cedis.
The National Buffer Stock Company, an agency under the Ministry of Food and Agriculture, which buys foodstuff from rural areas for distribution to other parts of the country, confirms it is anticipating food shortage next year, but says plans are in place to deal with the problem. Eric Osewusu is chief executive.
Yes, indeed there has been, because the maize supply and basically I'll say grains supply has been a little, you know, short than we normally get it. And that is because the rainfall patterns wasn't that good in the last planting season. And as a result of that, you know, caused yields to be very low, or relatively low, I would say. And so we are not getting as much grains on the market this season as we normally would expect. But as it is right now, there are grains in the system. Prices may be a little bit, you know, higher than we would expect, but it's nothing alarming.
Climate change is the cause of these unpredictable weather patterns. Scientists say it's nothing spiritual, but in the Techiman municipality, Islamic leaders held a special prayer session last month to call on God to cause the rain to fall. In order for crops to do well on the field, they require reasonable amounts of water over an extended period of time. But what climate change has caused are heavy rains at the start of the season and long periods of drought. Both tend to destroy farms. The lack of rains has now become a cycle, repeating itself every 4 to 7 years. David Asaresiama of Agro Mindset Organization wants policymakers to tackle the root cause of the problem.
Things are getting more unpredictable because farmers depend on information to do what they have to do. The time is going to rain, the amount of rain you are going to have and all that. That can even determine what you grow. And some of the most important impacts of this global climate change will be felt among populations, predominantly in developing countries, referred to as subsistence or smallholder farmers. And their vulnerability to climate change, or our vulnerability, because most of the farming activities that go on here are small-scaled, you see, comes from both being predominantly located in the tropics and from the various socioeconomic, demographic and policy trends which will limit their capacity to adapt to change. That is the whole beef. How they adapt to the change.
Climate change is an alteration in the statistical distribution of weather patterns over long periods of time. Civil society groups want government and Ghanaians in general to do more to deal with climate change.
Of particular concern is forests. The forest cover in Ghana has been reduced quite significantly over the last 30 years. The figures are very low. And if we continue to deplete the forests, we all know there's talk about climate change and how it's impacting on our lives. Sources of water, water catchment areas are being destroyed, and that is impacting again on people who already live on the margins, people who are exposed to all these risks around weather and climate, food security issues. So again, I think Ghana could have done, can do, and must do better in terms of preserving the environment, a major program is needed for reafforestation. We must plant trees in the millions over the next few years if we are to minimize the impact of climate change and the hazards of weather.
Until a turnaround is seen in policy and attitude, you can expect Ghana to return to this story in the next few years. The country must act now to stop climate change. For Joy News Exclusive, my name is Joseph Opoku Gakpo.